That's a clever nothing to play with.
You can hate me now.
I won't stop.
But I won't stop now.
We're here in California's capital, Sacramento, and a look here at the Capitol building. The Heat are out of Miami and into an interconference game. There's no better time of year than the holidays for NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Welcome, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. The starting fives for our game. Here are tonight's starting lineups. And as we take a look here at Chauncey Billups, guys, what's your take?
You know, it's been interesting to see how Chauncey Billups
career has changed as he's grown. Early on, he was known more as an offensive point guard, and then he became a playmaker for the Pistons during that championship season in that era. And now he's really become a spot-up shooter and a dead-eye marksman for his club.
And that's not to say that he can't do anything else, but he has really stepped up his shooting from deep. Not a lot of guards can go from carrying the ball handling duty to being a catch-and-shoot guy, but Chauncey has made the transition quite smoothly.
You look at Sacramento. This has been a tough stretch of games for them, fellas, losing their last four.
Well, I tell you what, Kevin.
Here's Billups, right now averaging 7 points a game. Leaps for it, and that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Take a look at the Heat. They've been in peak form as we've watched them play some tremendous basketball with an eye toward the postseason. And, of course, the Cavaliers, 7 games back.
Well, you know, looking at Miami, they've really caught nobody by surprise this year. I mean, they've got a tremendous track record and the talent to stay on top for a while.
Yeah, and, you know, some people wondered if there'd be a drop-off this season just because of those high expectations, but there really hasn't been a drop-off at all.
You know, Miami went to that smaller lineup last season, and a big change in that was having Chris Bosh move over to the five spot. Not his natural position, but I thought he held his own both offensively and defensively playing in the middle.
Way to play in attack mode and get inside.
And, you know, if you're on defense and you're going to foul, make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one.
The Kings shooting their first free throws of the game right now. Free throw good, Vasquez. And for Bosch, playing the center, Steve, he's giving up some weight out there.
But he's a very smart defender. He avoids fouls. And, you know, the way the league is these days, Kevin, most teams play smaller. And Bosch can normally find a center that he can guard without too much trouble. But there are a few matchups around the league that are a problem.
Well, they got the speed and the pressure that Miami defense. You know, you think they're able to compensate for any lack of size inside by using those other things.
Yeah, that's normally the case against, I would say, the vast majority of the league.
Billups kicks to Bosch. Billups, a screen on Cousins. Battier sets the pick for James. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
Much has been made about the show LeBron puts out during games, but he also puts on a spectacle in his pregame routine. Last season, he and others started pulling out all the stops and dunking in the pregame warm-up in an effort to break a sweat.
The first free throw is good. And, Clark, you mentioned the pregame dunks for LeBron, a devastating finisher. Some have asked why he's never competed in the All-Star Slam Dunk competition. In fact, I say that every Saturday night I'm sitting on that microphone. Why isn't LeBron in this competition?
Wouldn't it be nice? In fact, I think, didn't Magic Johnson even put up a $1 million incentive
for him
to compete? Yeah, it would be incredible to see him. I don't know. I think it's become almost a chore for players these days to enter, but it would be fantastic to see him out there.
Vasquez gets a screen from Wolf. Off the pick. Vasquez, that's good.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that one.
Bosch sets the pick for James. He took good advantage of that screen.
Solid screen right there that freed him up for the jump shot.
The Miami Heat comes into this one following a loss to the Lakers in Los Angeles.
Yeah, it was tough to see that one coming, really, because I thought that was a game they were going to win. The final score really caught a lot of people off guard.
Yeah, but I think they really tightened up at the end, Steve. I think they were trying too hard to avoid the upset instead of focusing on going after the win. Now, there's something for the top 10 highlight reel right there. A layup can be just as sweet and as pretty as a dunk sometimes.
Phillips dishes to Battier. Now the feed to James. Bosch, a screen on Selmans. The timely screen gave him a step, and he took it all the way. And that's now 6 points for LeBron. Vasquez passes to Wolf. It's stolen by Wade. Cashes in for a double-digit lead.
Now I'll tell you what, they've been a step slow here early on.
I agree with you. I mean, they're allowing too many open shots. They've seemed a little sluggish to me.
Thomas goes in. Here's Wolf. That's in there. Thomas with the assist. The machine's got his second basket of the game. Miami leading by 8. Right now we're going to go to Doris Burke, who spoke with head coach Eric Spoelstra. What'd you find out, Doris?
Kevin, he told me he stressed to his players that what he wanted more than anything tonight was the extra pass. He said, we have a lot of guys on this roster that can be factors on offense. As long as we're keeping everyone involved, we can overwhelm teams with our scoring. Let's see if they can keep the rock moving and share the ball, guys.
Okay, Doris, well, the offensive approach, a primary force in the game plan today, guys.
As it should be, Kevin. I mean, they're the type of team where if they can get their offense clicking, everything else falls into place.
Exactly. For them, more than most teams, so much depends on the effectiveness of their offense. It usually is the beginning of their best defense.
And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession.
A chance here to see how the Kings rank in the NBA right now. First in field goal percentage. First in three-point field goal percentage. And they're number 2 in assists. This is a team that loves to share the basketball.
And the shooting is really what stands out to me. This is a team that does such a good job of finding open looks. They're unselfish. They work offensively to create good shots. And when they do that and they're on their game, they're tough to beat.
Here's James. Soft touch off the glass. James has got 8 points.
They've worked hard and created great chances for themselves in this opening quarter.
Well, if they can match that effort at the defensive end, look out.
Thomas kicks to Selmans. Here's the machine. James covering. Kicks it out to Vasquez. Drains it from beyond the arc. He's got 7.
You know, even though he doesn't really have the long-range ability on a consistent level, he can knock down some open ones.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Mike Malone as he addressed his team. He said, I want to see us threading passes into the post all day long. That is what is going to trigger our offense. The other thing he discussed with them was that they should be forceful with the ball. He said if they see a gap in the defense, they should go straight to the bucket. Guys, we'll just have to watch how it plays out here in the first half. Kevin, back to you.
Great. Thanks for the report, Doris. Thomas against Phillips. Thomas goes in. Can't cash in from close range.
Usually if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. But the defense stood tall there.
Phillips, no good. So for the Kings, they come in off the loss to the Pelicans.
And that's the kind of loss that sticks with you for a while, guys, because they were probably the better team that night. And they just couldn't put the game away.
You know, Steve, you'd almost rather get beaten by double digits than know you should have won it, but didn't.
Selmans, you know what? Some solid defense from Battier. Miami leading by 8. Bosch sets the pick for LeBron. Phillips attacking. The jump hook hits the front of the rim and out.
Very porous defense down there by the hoop. He probably should make that one.
And it'll be Sacramento as it goes out of bounds. The Kings retaining possession.
Now, that pass had just a little bit too much heat on it for him to make a clean steal.
Yeah, I think it would have been a tough catch for either of them.
The Heat making a switch here. Greg Oden, he's checked in for Bosch. Haslam comes in for Shane Battier. Ray Allen, he's checked in for Dwayne Wade. And it's Chalmers in for Chauncey Billups. Here's McCallum. Shot clock at 6. Here's Wolf. Goes to the reverse layup and taps it in. The Machine's got his third basket of the night.
One of the sweetest moves in the game, the reverse layup in traffic.
Kicks it out to Allen. Passes it to Chalmers. Now Haslam inside. No luck. Excellent D there from Wolf. The Kings trail by six. Here's McCallum. And that one's good.
Beautiful finger roll to cap that drive off. He knows how to finish with some flair and flavor, guys.
The Heat have gone 8 of 15 from the field, shooting above 50% here tonight. James with it, picked up by Thompson. LeBron dishes to Chalmers. Chalmers off the pick from James. And Chalmers kicks to Haslam. And there's the pass to LeBron. The turnaround jumper, count it. James has got 13.
Very well done. He is a confident, dynamic scorer.
Redette gets a screen from Wolf. Fires for three. Another three for Sacramento.
You know, Heat head coach Eric Spoelstra worked his way up from the very bottom in that organization. I mean, he got his start as a video coordinator, and through years of hard work and dedication, has really become an outstanding coach.
Here's Oden. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. Oden's got his first 2 points.
You know, that's been a big part of their offense in the early stages. I mean, their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range right at the rim.
And I would continue to do it. You know, force the defense to maybe send a double team. Now you've got other options to work with offensively.
And back to Coach Eric Spoelstra. As a guy who got his start as a video coordinator, picking the game apart, Stevie's very comfortable with the new advanced stat movement analytics in the NBA.
Yeah, and I've had a chance to speak with him quite a bit. He says that the way they use advanced stats is just as a conversation piece in the coaching room. Their analytics department will bring them various information, and it will force them to ask questions, which is very healthy for a coaching staff to do.
Pass to McCallum, kicks it to Thompson. Makes it off the glass. Thompson's got his first bucket of the night.
And you can feel the pattern of this game, guys. They're working it inside, dominating in the paint, getting good shots at will.
Well, four of their last five baskets, guys, have been of exactly that variety.
And the Heat making a change here. Patterson against Haslam. Now here's Patterson. He's covered closely. They get a hand on it. Cousins, the pass to Patterson. Six on the shot clock. The Kings need to get off a shot here. From deep three-point range. Can't get it to go. And it's Miami the other way. Last time they met was in Miami.
And you just had to admire the versatility they showed offensively that day.
Yeah, their scoring came from all over the place. If one approach didn't work for them, they found another that did.
Wolf, he's in at power forward. Isaiah Thomas out there with Vasquez. Then there's DeMarcus Cousins. And it's Patterson in at the small forward position. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. Pass to Wolf. Haslam against Patterson. Here's Thomas. Rebound by the Heat. Wade's got his fourth rebound in this one.
Such a solid performance for them inside. The rebounding has been terrific.
Yeah, that's just one of the few things that have gone their way today.
Haslam, that's good.
You know, passing the ball well on the perimeter has really opened things up offensively for this club.
Steve, it makes the game easy. I mean, 10 straight points off assist. That's impressive, but it's easy when you move the ball.
Here's the Machine. He's guarded by Haslam. Outside Thomas. Out of bounds. Kings ball as Sacramento keeps possession. And while we can, let's find out a little bit about the shooting guards around the league and which of them have had the most assists over the last 10 games. The fourth spot held by Dwayne Wade.
That list of players just goes to show that great passing doesn't just come from the point. And the way these guys distribute the ball from the two spot is really a thing of beauty.
And Steve, if you want to take your place among the great shooting guards in the NBA, you have to be able to do more than score. You got to pass it as well. And a lot of these guys can.
Greg Oden, he's checked in for Chris Bosh. The Heat leading by 13.
Well, Miami stormed through the regular season and were viewed as the clear-cut favorites to come out of the East, but it was not as easy as expected. After sweeping Milwaukee, the Bulls gave them a scare, then the Pacers really took them deep all the way to Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals.
Vasquez passes to Wolf. And Shane Battier gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul.
And the next foul will put them over the limit and in the bonus.
A chance to get some easy points at the line here, so it makes sense to be aggressive.
There's Thomas with the three.
We'll see if they can make some adjustments at halftime to try to get him some easier looks and get him on track.
LeBron dishes to Billups. Wade outside. Tries from seven. Off the left rim and out. And for the Heat, the Pacers were their first real test, it seemed, and they had to survive a win or go home against them. It almost seemed, Clark, to take away any momentum they might have had when they went up against the Spurs in the finals.
You know, it's interesting. When I think of momentum in the playoffs, it doesn't carry over from game to game or series to series. I think each game, Kevin, is really an entity in and of itself. That said, Miami found a way, despite being pushed by the Pacers and being pushed by the Spurs, both to Game 7. It came down to LeBron James's brilliance, but also the hot shooting of a complimentary role-playing winner, Shane Battier.
Count that one. 10 points for the Machine.
I'll tell you what I love about him, his ability to finish even while absorbing contact. He is so strong, even with defenders hanging all over him, he continues to finish at the basket.
And he is also a tireless worker under the glass, Steve. More than a few guys have been on the receiving end of one of his elbows when a rebound is up for grabs. He uses his body very well.
Five to shoot, and it's James missing. The Kings trail by 15, and Doris Burke has something for us. Hey, Doris.
Hi, guys. The Machine in their last game against the Pelicans had a huge game. He finished with 30 points, and along with what he did on the offensive end, he also played some stellar defense as well. Numbers like that make you anxious to see what he can do next time out.
Great, Doris. Thanks. Any chance we see him top that performance, Clark, here tonight?
I'd say no chance, partner. And that's not a knock against him. It's just that he was so good that night, I don't think he can possibly do it two games in a row.
He was Kelloggian. Is that a word? We can use that word, can't
we? It is now.
Oh, look at Steve. He didn't like that, though. Look at him.
Let's just say he was really good.
That free throw good from Wolf.
When you're hot, and that's certainly been the case for the Machine. He has 11 points, and he's made some good decisions with the basketball, too.
Well, being smart is what it's all about for him, Clark. I mean, he's a decision maker. He's a playmaker. He has to make good decisions. That's what he's doing here so far.
And the Kings making a change here. Salmons has checked in. Both free throws good from Wolf.
In the second quarter, they've had the right approach. Very aggressive, driving, drawing contact, and creating opportunities at the free throw line.
Well, you know, if other things aren't working for you, Steve, getting to the foul line can be a good place to start to turn it around.
And look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Heat.
They're making a concerted effort to get to the free throw line in the first half, guys, and they're cashing in.
Another thing they've been doing so far tonight is knocking down the jump shot.
And he makes the first.
A lot was made about the Kings in their home last year, but it wasn't about how well are they playing at home. It was about where is their home going to be next season. The Kings are staying in Sacramento, but they
play like it might be their last hurrah.
Both free throws good from James. And you go back to the Kings at home last year, 20-21 record, and it was easy to see just how much tougher a team they were in this building. You know, Steve, they really looked like a team that could compete with anyone at any time.
Well, this community really rallied behind the franchise, and there was a lot of worry that maybe this was the farewell tour for the Kings fans and the players, and they played their hearts out last year. You got to give them a lot of credit for really fighting, particularly down the stretch when things looked good.
Thomas passes to Wolf, tries to save it, and that's out of bounds. Sacramento will retain possession.
Here's a look at some stats for Greivas Vásquez. How his last 10 games have gone. He's averaging 8 points, 4 assists, and 4 rebounds. And some pretty good numbers, I think, guys, when you look overall at his contributions.
Yeah, and he's always looking to raise his game, and that's what you see in his consistency. One of the important characteristics that he brings to the table.
That is good. And the Heat call time here. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Guys, over that last break, I listened to Eric Spoelstra address his team. Back to fundamentals. That's what he told them. Specifically, he'd like to see them implement the pick and roll as often as possible. Maybe making those early adjustments will give them time to judge their effectiveness by halftime. We'll soon find out, Kevin.
Thanks a lot, Doris. Wade with it. 9 points in the game so far. Billups inside the line. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Wade's got his 5th assist in this one. Thomas off a pick from Wolf. Vasquez passes to Wolf. And there are the Kings with another bucket.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
Miami leading by 15. Battier sets the pick for Wade. He feeds it to Billups. Lets it go from the wing. It's rebounded by Wolf. The Machine's got his 5th rebound in this one. Vasquez passes to Wolf. Thompson right side. Salmons against LeBron. Here's Wolf. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that. The Machine's got 8 points in the quarter. For Miami, they've gone 7-13 from the field since the start of the second. Billups kicks to Oden. There's 1:38 left now here in the second. Battier. And it's off from 3-point range. The Kings trail by 13. It's Thomas outside. Count that one. Thomas got 5 points so far.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any agenda.
It's hard to overstate all the points they've scored on assists today. Beautiful to watch.
Out of bounds, Sacramento will take possession.
Here's a look at some stats for Greivas Vásquez. How last month turned out for him. 6th in 3-point field goal percentage. And he's been such a good offensive player. His patience, his efficiency, he's ranked in the top 10 in field goal percentage.
And Steve, I really think he deserves an awful lot of credit for making it into the top 10 in 3-point shooting. I mean, that's pretty high quality marksmanship when you're a top 10 3-point shooter.
And Miami making a change here. Vernado's checked in. Vasquez passes to Wolf. Taken away. And here's Wade. He's coming off a 16-point game against the Lakers. Feeds it to Billups. Back to Wade. Down low. No good from Vernado.
He's far too tentative in the paint. And even more so when the defender is up tight on him like that time.
Vasquez kicks to Selmans. He dishes it to Vasquez. Off target from 3-point range.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
The feed to LeBron. There's the dish to Vernado. It's back to Battier. That one's off, still out of sync. Here's the Machine. He's got 16. Salmons from outside. Shot is off. And so that's the end of the first half. Miami ahead, up 10. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Hi, Kevin. Well, Coach, LeBron obviously having a tremendous game so far. What is key to his ability to take over a game?
It's probably a myriad of things, but his ability to sustain that. He came out with great force and got us off on the right note. Now we have to keep it going.
Coach, thanks for the time. Gentlemen, back to you.
All right, Doris, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow here on 2K Sports.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Let's get into the first half breakdown. We're starting to get into the thick of the NBA season. Miami up on top against the Kings in Sacramento. Playing great basketball of late, this game's no different. A sensational first half for LeBron. He has 17 points, and he's been working to get great looks from the field, making his trips to the free throw line count as well. And doing their best to stay alive, the Sacramento Kings. They've gotten a tremendous boost from their reserves, going to them early in the game for production. The machine has had himself an amazing start. What he's been able to do from the field has been nothing short of spectacular. Only a select few players in the league can shoot the ball like that. And we'll be heading back to the court for the rest of our coverage as we go to Kevin Harlan, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke for the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And now the third quarter, about to get going. What can you say, LeBron James? What an impressive effort today.
It seemed like he made everything he got. I mean, anytime he had an open look, he took advantage of the opportunity there in that first half.
And Steve, they were all good looks. I mean, his shot selection has been terrific throughout the game.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. And for Miami, looking who they've got out there. On the wings, it's D. Wade and LeBron James. Chris Bosh is out there with Shane Battier. And it's Billups in at the point guard position.
Well, I tell you what, Isaiah Thomas, guys, was the last pick of the second round. 60th overall his draft year, but he has been terrific. Can pass and score and has stepped into the starting point guard role for the Kings and showed he belonged.
And the first one drops. We're going back to Isaiah Thomas and the Kings. They really needed a true point guard to set the table for everybody. His emergence was a pretty nice story for this team.
Well, he's always been doubted because he's only 5'9". And, he wasn't drafted high, wasn't recruited that heavily. But I think he's demonstrated that he can hold his own with the best in this league.
And good on the second, so he makes them both.
Boy, his free throw shooting, just another reason. He's such a good all-around player.
Billups kicks to Bosh. Dishes to Wade. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Wade's got 11.
Well, that's one way to get your second half started on the right foot. An easy layup against some soft defense.
Passes it to Salmons. Here's the machine. He's guarded by Battier. And that's out of bounds. Sacramento will retain possession. Now we have a chance to see the teams that have been the NBA's best three-point shooters this month. The Heat in fifth.
Seems like their whole team is in a great rhythm from the three-point line right now. They've put on a display from long range.
Salmons passes to Wolf. Shot clock at 6. He kicks to Cousins. Knocked loose. Battier with the steal. And it's Wade penetrating. Here's Billups. And that one hits back iron.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
Now the pass to Salmons. kicks to Vasquez. Pass to Wolf. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. We'll take a look at the Nuggets. Quite a season they've assembled here, guys. Perched up there in first place and playing terrific basketball game in and game out. And, of course, Sacramento, not in the same realm right now in terms of their record.
You know, for the Kings, they've not achieved any of even the most modest goals they've set for themselves so far.
Well, it's been a tough, tough year, Clark, no question. There was a lot of talk for them before the season about, you know, proving the doubters wrong. But at this point, the doubters look right.
Vasquez dishes to Selmans. That's good. Selmans got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Kings.
That lead pass allowed him to get straight to the hoop without losing any momentum.
LeBron with a screen on Thomas. And it's Wade penetrating. And he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick. Wade's got 13.
Well, you gotta like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates.
Thomas kicks to Cousins. And it's blocked by Bosch. Tries again. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. And Chauncey Billups the bucket on the assist by Wade. Wade's got his sixth assist on the night.
You know, it's not so much that the Heat score a lot of points. It's just that they score them in spurts. And it almost is a surprise when they end a possession without scoring or getting an easy shot. So good at spacing the floor and moving the ball.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Hi, Kevin. I was able to hear the advice Mike Malone gave to his team during that last break. The ball has to be fed into the low post much more than it has been to this point. That was his message. He said, they're giving us room down low. Let's take advantage of it. He told them also they should be swarming to the basket at the offensive end. He wants a lot of bodies inside. Clearly, some adjustments there had to be made because the time left for a comeback is quickly running out. Kevin, over to you.
Thanks again, Doris. Bosch passes to Billups. Battier outside. Back to Billups. Miami needs to get a shot off. From deep. Rebounded by Wolf. The Machine's got his eighth rebound here tonight. And Clark, just as you said, the Heat just so efficient offensively. Made about half those shots they took on the year and ended up with the best shooting percentage, Steve, in the NBA.
So it was all about floor spacing and LeBron, Kevin. They put shooters everywhere, but LeBron and Wade would attack, and they had really good flow and movement with the ball. And I think over time now, given this team 3 years now, it's one of the best offenses in the league.
Vasquez passes to Wolf. Here's Cousins. Oh, yes, the turnaround. Cousins has got his first bucket of the night.
Such a difficult shot to defend, that turnaround.
Miami leading by 8. Wade dishes to Haslam. And it's the Machine with the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. A different look for Miami. Allen comes in for Dwayne Wade. And it's Chalmers in for Chauncey Billups. Bosch against Landry. And Haslam kicks to LeBron. And good on the basket. Book it. LeBron's got 19 points.
And another gap in the defense found right there. This is one of the worst defensive performances I have ever seen.
Outside Thomas. James against Selmans. Softly drops in the floater. Selmans got 4 points in the quarter.
You know, if you were only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would be ahead.
LeBron against Selmans. James, the pass to Chalmers. James outside, 6 to shoot. Fires for 3, and it's Mario Chalmers with the 3. Chalmers has got 5.
Yeah, something that makes him hard to defend is his ability to receive a pass and get off an accurate shot in one quick fluid motion, so you better beware of where he is on the floor at all times.
One of the premier catch-and-shoot guys in the league, Steve. There's no question about it.
Anthony's checked in for Miami. Miami leading by 11. Here's James. He's got 19. Ray Allen is on the wing. Back to James. Can't hit. Some solid D from Salmons. For Sacramento, they've gone 4-6 from the field since the start of the third.
After having a strangely off year from behind the arc in the 2011-12 season, John Salmons got back to his usual sharp shooting ways last year, guys. He shot over 37% from long range.
How huge has he been, giving his team the lift?
Without his work offensively, Steve, I don't know where they'd be. Shooting at great efficiency, I don't think they'd have a chance without him.
Allen drives in. Back to LeBron. Allen outside. And the basket good. And the Heat lead by 11. Well, and for Salmons, a starter last season in Sacramento, played almost as much as Tyreke Evans.
And that might be a stretch for Salmons at this point in his career. He's a decent passer and defender, but he shot under 40% from the field. You know, he's gotten older. He's been a very solid player throughout his career, but I think the older legs are starting to catch up.
Pass to Landry. Second shot opportunity, and it's laid up and in on a nice move that time from Wolf.
I think they've got to keep getting him the ball. When he's going like that, he's in the zone right now. Perfect from the field. You've got to continue to milk the hot hand.
Here's Chalmers, rejected by Wolf. Now, here is Fredette. Right now averaging 5 points a game. Andrea screen on Anthony. Wolf passes to Landry. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
You know, Carl Landry has throughout his career played mostly as a reserve, but he is a super sub, a guy who gives you starter caliber scoring and competes defensively on the backboards. That's just what you want off the bench on your front line.
Free throw drops for Landry. Well, going back to Landry, a late bloomer, certainly cut from the freshman team in high school. You know the story, barely made the JV team. He didn't play consistent minutes until his senior year, and Carl Landry has become, in a lot of ways, indispensable for Golden State.
And it was in junior college, Kevin, that he really found his game. His coach told him to be more aggressive, looking to score, and once he did that, he really discovered he had a gift for it, and then of course went on to Purdue and had an excellent college career.
And both free throws good for Landry.
And you look at Landry, and he does lack the size of most power forwards, but he's excellent at finishing around the goal, and it helps him keep defenders honest with a nice reliable outside shot too.
He's been so reliable again today, Kevin. They need his points and he's providing them.
That's his first personal foul.
And Carl Landry's such a great knack for scoring around the rim.
He's a tough guy, a genuine tough guy. Gets the ball in the paint, and he'll go up and score with little jump shots or maybe put-back shots. Great hands, and really keeps himself in good condition.
Well, LeBron James was probably his best season statistically a year ago. I don't think there's any question about it, guys. I mean, certainly it was his most efficient offensive season. I mean, he had career highs of 56% shooting from the floor and 41% from long range. I don't know if we've seen a player of his size put together those kinds of numbers with the types of shots that he takes. I mean, just absolutely stunning what he did in terms of his efficiency last season.
Chalmers dishes to LeBron. Here's Varnado. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. LeBron's got his third assist on the night.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
And for LeBron James, the season before last, he really focused on scoring in the post. You know, Steve, using his size and strength.
And we've seen his field goal percentage climb as a result. The low post work, I think the selection too, shoots fewer three-pointers, but a higher percentage. So now, you know, how do you guard the guy? He's got everything in the package.
Here's Cole. He's guarded by McCallum. And he takes that one up and powers it through. Clark, some serious agility coming out of the backcourt.
You know, that bucket might count for a little more than 2 points when he finishes with that kind of flourish.
Yeah, against a D that was already reeling a little bit. That was like a body blow.
Passes it to Wolf. They set the pick. He feeds it to Fredette for the three. And another three for Sacramento.
Third three in a row right there.
Adjustment time for the defense, guys.
Miami leading by five. Here's Cole. LeBron outside. High arcing shot. And there it is again. Nice make there from Cole.
Boy, you gotta love that assist by LeBron.
Fredette gets a screen from Wolf. Fredette kicks to McLemore. And the pass to McCallum. Out left to the wing. Now, here is Fredette. Defended by Chalmers. And he gets it to go.
Seems to me as though they've kicked it into another gear here. I love the way they're moving the ball around now. Everybody's touching it. And everybody's ready to pass and catch and shoot.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Well, guys, I was able to listen in on what Eric Spoelstra was going over with his team in that last huddle. He mentioned defensive strategy right away. He wants fewer bodies in the paint and more.
Miami with the ball. 17 points was their biggest margin. Bosch passes to Wade. Back to Bosch. Out to Battier. And stolen by Cousins. Wolf in at power four. Vasquez out there with Isaiah Thomas. Then it's Salmons. And it's Cousins in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. James in the post, covered by Wolf. Billups. Rebound by the Kings. Thomas got his third rebound tonight. Pass to Wolf. Dives for it. That's good. It's Thomas picking up the assist. 24 points for the Machine.
That's some grit and determination in the post. Essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Exactly. I mean, this is the time to attack on the interior and generate those easy opportunities.
Battier's shot good.
It makes it so easy for your teammate when you can lead him with a pass like that one.
Now here's Vasquez. He's tightly guarded, and that one's good.
What a display of offense we've seen today, and it's only getting better.
Well, both defenses have been on their heels all day, and it's begun to take its toll.
Wade dishes to LeBron. Banked in off the glass. James has got 26 points.
You know, they've been able to depend on his offense all game long, guys. He's drained a lot of shots out here.
And between now and the horn, Steve, the ball should be in his hands as much as possible if they want to continue to build this lead.
Well, I tell you, that was double duty right there. He influenced the shot and then got back and cleaned the glass.
Billups with the ball. Now Thomas defending. And the shot is good. And now it's a 9-point Miami lead. Sacramento's gotten the three-point bug tonight. They've taken 15 shots outside the arc. They're 6 of 15. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Well, he's forcing the issue out there, guys. No question. He's really struggling trying to take care of the ball.
Well, Heat leading by 9. Outside, Billups. Banked in off the glass. Billups has got 6 points in the quarter.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Vasquez passes to Wolf. feeds it to Cousins. And out of bounds as the Heat gain possession. And a moment to check out Miami and who they've got coming up. They get to take on the Blazers at Portland after this one. That is game three of this four-game trip.
A lot of attention on the Nuggets. You know, that game, that Denver game really is interesting to watch.
The Heat have gone 5 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Strong work at that end of the floor. Salmons against James. He dishes it to Wade. No good with the triple. The Kings trail by 11. Vasquez with it. Wade picks him up. And out of bounds as the Heat gain possession. Chance to check out the Sacramento Kings' upcoming schedule. After this one, they're off to San Antonio to take on the Spurs. And that'll be the first of a two-game road trip for them. Here's James. Out to the wing. Billups goes in, and the shot is good. Billups has got 8 here in the quarter.
Well, he wasn't fazed at all by the bigger man on him, and on the low block, I thought he might be.
You know, Steve, I thought maybe he'd prefer to bring him out to the perimeter, but whatever works, go to it.
And Shane Battier gets the whistle that time. And that'll be his third foul so far. And the Kings making a change here. Landry's checked in. To halt the run. And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. And this one was such a lopsided victory.
They never let up. They were full throttle from the start.
And now let's go over to Doris Burke on the sideline for an interview with the Jordan Player of the Game. Doris, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. LeBron, you are in the midst of yet another great season, posting tremendous individual numbers and the team with an outstanding record. Is this the type of season that you set out to achieve right from the get-go?
I just wanted to play well. You know, this whole season, you know, I got back to what I know I'm capable of doing, and that's having fun with this game and, you know, just believing in myself and my teammates. So I'm happy to be in a good place.
Thank you so much. Back to you guys at the table.
All right, Doris, thank you. And for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in to the NBA on 2K Sports. Now, our Jordan Player of the Game, LeBron James.
Well, it's been a few days, so where do things stand now? Still want to be traded? Because remember, if we go down this road, there's no turning back.
Yeah, I'm definitely ready to get out of here.
All right, I'll see what I can do. But you need to know I'm not going to make a move just for the sake of making a move. I need to ensure it's in the best interest of this organization. I can't promise anything, but why don't you let me know what teams you're interested in? Okay, if I can find something that makes sense, you'll get your wish.
Just make it happen. Thanks.
Thanks for coming up. Just wanted to give you a quick update on how things are progressing. I talked to Coach and he agrees. You've been playing well lately. He thinks you're close to being ready for the starting lineup.
Woo! Yo, it's about time. I was ready weeks ago. I know I can help this team win games. Y'all just gotta put me out there, man.
Your confidence is appreciated, no doubt. But Coach knows what he's doing, and when he thinks you're ready, you'll get the call. In the meantime, just keep working hard.
Yo, I bring it every night. I'm saying, just tell Coach I'm ready now.
Look, I trust Coach to make the right decision on when you're ready. Just keep doing what you're doing. You're going to be in the starting lineup before you know it.
All right, man, you're the boss. I just hope my name's in that lineup soon, because this beast needs to be unleashed. You feel me?
Oh, yeah.